wrestling fans, and welcome to another exciting edition of UWC Championship Wrestling. I'm Chris Wilcox, and we have a great wrestling show for you this week. We're going to take a look at the career of the former UWC Heavyweight Champion, Biggie Biggs. Now first, let's show you exactly how he won that title. We're going to go back to December of last year. It's the annual UWC Toys for Tots Spectacular. He was involved in a three-way dance with Reckless Youth and Twiggy Ramirez, the then UWC Heavyweight Champion. Now, we've never shown this match for free on YouTube, on UWC Championship Wrestling. This is the first time we've ever shown it, and we're going to show it to you in its entirety. We're going to show you exactly how Biggie Biggs won the UWC Heavyweight Championship. Let's take a look.
And we're getting set for action right here. Twiggy Ramirez hitting the ring in a house of fire. Reckless Youth backing off.
Twiggy firing away on Reckless Youth. Chris, we're here, we're calling this big three-way match between Reckless Youth, Twiggy Ramirez, and Biggie Biggs.
Yeah, we're at the UWC Studios in Woodbury, Connecticut, in Woodbury, New Jersey.
Dude, Dennis, get out of here. Dude.
I thought he was dead.
No, he's not. Reckless just clears the ring.
And wait, well, there's got a brawl on the outside. Devastation LLC brawl with Adam Aces, Warhead. It looks like Taylor Nichols out there. I think, is that Andy Bivens?
It looks like Andy Bivens. I was going to say, keep your eye on Reckless Youth, but he seems just content to let these guys just beat the hell out of each other.
Now, if this took place back in December, at this point, Biggie Biggs and Twiggy Ramirez still having a lot of problems, and both men having problems with Reckless Youth, as so many people seem to do.
Well, you know, Reckless Youth is a heat magnet. That's his, you know, moniker in this business. Oh, Reckless Youth now looking to hit something on Twiggy.
Bouncing off the ropes, he's going to do his baseball slide. Yes! Right to the side of the head. Now he's fighting on the outside. Oh, slams him right into the ring apron. And all three men are outside right now. George Naha putting the count on. We could see a count out right here.
Well, I don't think George Naha wants to count any of these guys out. This is a huge match. And at the time, you know, all these three guys were vying for the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
And two of these men still are. The current champion is Jeffrey Bravo. Oh, big Luthes press and the punches. Shades of Stone Cold Steve Austin. George Naha trying to step in there, maybe.
Well, Twiggy Ramirez clearly got the fire in the crowd behind him, sends Biggie Biggs headfirst into the top turnbuckle.
And now he reverses the whip, Irish whip in, oh, big boot. Twiggy Ramirez looking on, he's asking the crowd they want to see something.
Oh, big choke slam by Biggie Biggs, Twiggy might be out.
That's what the big man does best, just slams people around, throws them around the ring with ease. And now he's looking at Reckless Youth. He's blowing in the corner right here.
Oh, he's going to try to mount Reckless in the corner. I don't know if that's such a good idea.
So throwing the punches, one, two, three, count it at home.
You can count, that's pretty good. But let's see, we got, it's hard to tell here. Reckless is trying to find some sort of respite, but now Biggie Biggs just slamming him headfirst into all the turnbuckles.
Oh, he's looking worse for
that. Face first into the mat.
Reckless Youth looks groggy. Biggie Biggs taking control earlier. He's taking out both men single-handedly.
Now Biggie Biggs got Twiggy in the corner. Backs Twiggy up, whips him into the far corner.
Ooh, hits the corner hard.
Twiggy took that turnbuckle and right down to the mat.
Cover, two, only a two count.
Only a two count. Reckless Youth still trying to get back to his feet, obviously. First pinfall in this match wins.
The UWC Heavyweight Championship on the line. Reckless Youth in the corner and Biggie Biggs eyeing him up.
All three of these men have held the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
And Reckless Youth charging,
double knees.
Oh, monkey flip didn't quite get him over, but he still had a lot of impact on that one.
That's a big man to take over. Reckless Youth now off the ropes, senton splash, over for the cover. One, two, only a two.
And then look at that, Twiggy Ramirez lying in wait, taking advantage with those axe handles across the back.
Well, Twiggy and Biggie know each other well, and I think Twiggy knew that Biggie wasn't going to get pinned on that move.
Well, he's going for the backslide right here. Shades of Kerry Von Erich and Ric Flair.
This is how Kerry Von Erich won the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Kerry Von Erich is the one won the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
When he did up.
He's got him over. One, two.
No.
No, right the schoolboy. One, two.
And now Twiggy now up from behind. Inside cradle.
Two. Only a two count. All three men trying to get the pin right there. Oh!
All three men with the same idea. Both going for a punch.
But look at that. Biggie Biggs is still on his feet, though. It's hard to take the big man down.
But now he and Twiggy are exchanging blows. We've seen these two go at it many times. You know, these two have been very good friends, but they certainly like to beat the hell out of each other. And now Reckless Youth wanted them to beat each other up, and they said, screw you, Reckless, we're going to take you out.
That's that heat magnet right again getting taken out by two men. And then Now Biggie Biggs taking over. Big headbutt.
You know, I've heard reckless use has been taken out by two men many times in the past.
I don't want to hear about that.
Well, Twiggy now firing back on Biggie Biggs. Rakes the eyes. That's Biggie Biggs right there. He doesn't care what it takes. When the title's on the line, he'll do whatever it takes to win.
Off of the ropes. Twiggy coming. Big cross body block. Going for the cover. George over. Two.
Only a two count. As a little girl runs from ringside in fear.
Reckless Youth climbing up to the top rope. Going for the big atomic drop.
Big Manhattan drop by, oh, double noggin knocker there by accident. Oh, and Reckless will be singing soprano.
He's out in the corner right there. All three men now stunned right now. One of them has to take advantage if they want to walk out of here with the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Well, I don't know if Reckless is going to be walking out of this building at all. He might be, you know, carted out of here.
Look at that Twiggy season. Is he going for that superplex?
He's calling for the crowd's response. I think Twiggy's taking way too much time. Come on, Twiggy. You want to be the champion, you got to hit this move.
He's the champion going into this match.
Well, he won't be the champion for long. Can't pin Reckless Youth here.
He's going for the superplex. Biggie Biggs is right there, though. Are they going to stack him up?
They're taking way too much time. Biggie now. Could this be a Tower of Doom?
Oh!
Oh, big superplex.
The superplex by Twiggy, but Biggie powerbombs Twiggy out of the corner. I mean, all three men are down.
Well, we've seen this a lot in this match so far. All three of these men are just trying to take each other out. I don't think they really care who they pin. They just want to pin somebody.
Now, Mr. Black, you're the manager of the Secret Society.
Absolutely, and you notice none of these guys have masks on.
Wow. What would you do? How would you advise one of your men to try to take control here?
Well, what I would do is I would see that weird-looking guy who just came down to ringside?
That's Joe Rules.
I would tell the referee to pay attention to him, and then I'd come in, and I'd hit Twiggy Ramirez in the head with something. That's what I would do.
But look at this. Now CD4 in the ring.
They're not even involved in this match. I don't know what the heck they think they're doing.
It's no DQ, and they can be down there. Here comes Warhead and Adam Aces. They've even had their problems with CB4 in the past.
Well, Special Forces now taking out CB4.
That's where they're helping out their friend Twiggy Ramirez right here.
And you know, I just want to point out that many people gave former Commissioner Grimaldi a lot of grief over this, but George Panaha cannot control any of these title matches in UWC. You're clearly seeing this right here.
It's no DQ. You have Devastation LLC involved. What's Jeffrey Bravo out here?
Well, here's Jeffrey Bravo. Of course, we know the history he now has with Twiggy Ramirez, but Andy Bibbs from behind.
Andy Bibbs picking him up. Big scoop slam. They're going to have some matches in the near future, as you'll see.
Big thriller elbow drop. Takes Bravo down, Bravo out of the ring. Now it seems like we're back to just Twiggy, Biggie, and
Reckless. Yes. Now here comes Joe Rules.
What is Joe Rules doing in the ring? Look at him. He's screaming at Reckless Youth.
He's trying to give him instruction, but here comes his ex-wife, Taylor Nicole.
Big slap.
Big slap right to the face.
Oh, you know, I'm not a fan of Joe Rules, but I don't think he deserved that.
I think he deserved more than that. He's getting beat up on his way back to the locker room.
Oh, big spear by Twiggy Ramirez. That could be it. But Reckless Youth now, from behind, sends Twiggy into the turnbuckle.
Now he's taking him up to the top rope. We're going to see a hurricanrana or a suplex here.
Oh, he's going to go for the ace crusher.
Oh, bro, look at that. Twiggy lands up on top, though. Twiggy lands on top. Why isn't George got one to the count? There it is. One, two.
I don't think... Now Reckless is just grabbing the referee after Reckless hit the ace crusher on Twiggy. It's Reckless's fault that Twiggy's even on the cover.
No DQ in this match. So that's perfectly legal to assault the referee.
How is that perfectly legal? I mean, I can understand his frustrations. I wanted to kick the snot out of George plenty of times, but
I just hope Commissioner Grimaldi find him after that. Can you shed any light on that, Mr. Black?
I cannot shed any light on that. A lot of that is still under litigation. I'm not allowed to refer to a lot of the Commissioner Grimaldi stuff. And we see Twiggy now reversing. It could be going for that rock bottom.
There it is, rock bottom in the middle of the ring, but George is out.
There's absolutely no referee to count. And Twiggy's just looking around, looking for anybody.
Somebody send your friend Scott Volk out there to make a cover.
Well, you know, if the commissioner had not been getting so much grief, I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
Biggie Biggs is sizing him up.
Look at Twiggy. Twiggy's looking in the back for somebody.
There he is. There's Scott Volk. Ooh, stunner. Stunner.
Stunned by Biggie Biggs, over for the cover, one, two, and...
Oh!
Wow, I could have sworn he would have had him on that one.
Biggie Biggs still doesn't get the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Now Biggie just wondering what he has to do. Referee Scott Falk explaining it was only a two count.
He's trying to revive Reckless Youth there in the corner.
Why would he be trying to revive Reckless Youth?
Because you know he has every right to get in this.
Are
match.
You saying that the new commissioner of UWC is biased towards Reckless Youth?
Well, Reckless Youth doesn't even work here anymore, so I guess it's okay if he is.
Biggie was going for that big choke slam, but Twiggy reversing it. Face buster on the knee.
Off the ropes. And there's Reckless Youth with the big leg lariat, and that takes Twiggy out of the match.
And Reckless Youth now celebrating his big leg lariat.
Too early, it looks like.
Off the ropes.
Ah, sky-high powerbomb over the cover. Two, three, we have a new UWC heavyweight champion, even though he already lost it. But
with Biggie Biggs defeated Reckless Youth in this big three-way match to win the UWC championship back in December. Of course, we know what's happened since, but Biggie Biggs clearly wants another shot at that UWC title now.
He's always been a very fighting champion when he had the title, and he clearly deserved it. He beat two tough competitors to win that title.
Well, he beat two of the greatest that UWC has to offer. You know, I can say a lot about Reckless Youth being a heat magnet, a lot about Twiggy Ramirez being a suck-up, but all these guys are tremendous wrestlers, and they deserve to be.
Tremendous suck-up! He sucks up to you! I've heard nothing but good interactions with Mr. Ramirez.
Exactly.
Reckless Youth, I don't think he's happy with what went down right there. I think he felt he deserved to be the UWC heavyweight champion.
Well, you know, Reckless Youth does believe that he should be champion, but on this night, it just wasn't to be.
Wait just a minute. Is that Devastation LLC hitting the ring?
Devastation LLC from behind, taking Biggie Biggs out by the knee.
That looked like a low blow by CD4 Bubba, who go on to have his share of matches with Biggie Biggs.
And now we have a 5-on-1 assault here on Biggie Biggs. Reckless Youth on the middle turnbuckle. He's telling Devastation LLC to set him up for that big frog splash.
Going up to the top rope. Almost slips.
Well, Reckless Youth slips on the top rope, but
It's been a while since he's gone to that top rope.
Still 5-on-1. Whoa! Mellow salt!
It's the Marvelosity right there in the middle of the ring, but here comes Twiggy Ramirez. He's clearing the ring. Former champion, still a very proud fighting champion around here, and there goes Reckless Youth. The Big Rigs.
Big Rigs the only one left here. Oh, Jeffrey Bravo's in there, too.
Oh, and we know what those history, those guys have.
And now Bravo's out of there, and of course, Twiggy Ramirez signaling he wants the championship belt, but he lost that belt.
What's he going to do with it? Wait a second, he's looking for it. There's Andy Bibbins out there again, and I think I see Warhead and Adam Aces there in the corner.
You got a lot of people. This match is, and this everything has just been a complete.
Oh, wait, Twiggy gonna hit him? Is he gonna hit him? He's gonna hit him with the title belt.
Hit him, Twiggy. Hit him.
No,
hit
no,
him.
Don't hit him. Oh,
hit him.
Wait.
Hit him like a dog.
Don't we? Shut up, David Crockett.
Well, Twiggy now.
He's asking the fans what he should do. He's gonna present.
Oh, isn't that sweet?
Biggie Biggs accepts the title belt now. Look at Twiggy Ramirez, a true sportsman, leading the crowd in a round of applause for Biggie Biggs, the UWC Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, these two make me sick.
After he won the title, Biggie Biggs promised to be a fighting champion. And let's take a look at some of his successful UWC Heavyweight Championship defenses.
Kicked right to the face. Ropes. Sky high power bomb. 1, 2, 3. Biggie Biggs retains the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Rope. We've seen him go up with that senton before. That's a big guy up that high.
All right, Biggie back on his feet. I think Bubba's taking too long. He takes him down to the mat. Cover. 1, 2, 3. Biggie Biggs has retained the title.
Ropes. He's going to probably do some high flying right now.
Goes for the charge, misses.
Well, that's right. What he considers high flying.
He blocked it, though.
Wait!
Tells him to... Oh, there it is! The Biggie bombs.
And experience of Biggie,
big break. That's a freak out.
Now let's take a look at another exclusive match here on UWC Championship Wrestling. We have not shown this match for you previously. Biggie Biggs defending the UWC Heavyweight Championship against Professor Milo Shizo of the Secret Society. This was from our March 26th fundraiser for Project Graduation at Pemberton Township High School. Let's take a look at this big match.
All right, we are set for our main event here tonight. It's going to be Biggie Biggs defending the UWC Heavyweight Championship against a member of the Secret Society, Milo Shizo. And I'm joined right now by one half. What's your new tag team name?
That's mind and muscle.
Mind and muscle. That's Philly Madison right here.
That is textbook Philly Madison. Get it right.
I apologize.
Wilcox.
I apologize, textbook. Now, is textbook your first name or is it Philly?
Shut up.
All right.
Just watch the match. You're supposed to call these matches, right?
Right. Shiza's on the early going. He had an advantage, but now Biggie Biggs taking control.
Listen. All right. This Milo guy, he has a tail. Right?
Yes.
I don't know if the tail gives him balance during the match, or it just helps him, like, or it's just like a lucky charm. But I have a really good feeling that we're going to have a new UWC heavyweight champion right now.
That would be a big feather in the cap for the Secret Society. They're all at ringside right now. You see Mighty Moe and Diablo Hysterico.
Well, here's the thing. There's this strength in numbers. When you have numbers, when you have friends, that's it. You're always a winner. Biggie Biggs got no one out there right now. No one is going, no one rooting him on. All he has is the fans, and the fans are worthless. They can't help him at all.
We've seen the fans rally Biggie Biggs when it looked hopeless several times in the past.
Listen, they're trying to work that angle right now, and it's not going to work. Fans are worthless. They never do anything for anybody. All they do is just get in the way.
Well, you've been in the ring with Biggie Biggs in the past. What can you tell the fans about wrestling Biggie Biggs?
Listen. Me and Biggie Biggs go way back, even further than Biggie Biggs knows how far back we went. I used to watch Biggie Biggs in NWA New York when he was Ranger Nick, right?
Ranger Nick.
I was 12 years old. I think he's about like maybe 50, pushing 50, 60 now. But Biggie Biggs is a competitor. I'm not going to take anything away from him. You know, he's a little on the round side.
He's a big man.
My personal taste. But I guess that's where he gets the name Biggie Biggs. Yeah.
He's been the overweight lover in the past as well.
Yes, the overweight lover. When the honor roll took him away, and they took away his Ranger nickname, and they made him the overweight lover, Biggie Biggs. And I'm glad that he dropped the overweight lover, because that's just embarrassing.
Oh, and now Milo Shizo getting an advantage when the Secret Society gets in there, and now he's just taking
it. That's the strength in numbers, Chris. That's the strength in numbers. That's how we roll. I have a tag team partner watching my back, and I'll watch his.
Where's he right now? Why isn't he watching your back right here?
I don't need anyone watching my back right now. I'm pretty safe right now. I don't think anyone's going to really attack me. I'm just a color commentator right now. I'm just like you. Who's going to attack you?
Nah, that's a good point. Well, maybe go. If Grimaldi was here, he'd attack me.
I don't get me started with him.
All right. Well, Biggie Biggs on the receiving end right now. Milo Shizo graduated from the Ring of Honor School of Wrestling. He's trained by Delirious, and you can see the Delirious influence in Milo Shizo.
Listen, the only problem I have with this Milo guy is that he walks around thinking he's an actual professor. And some people might get the wrong idea in thinking that he might be the smartest wrestler here in the UWC. But we all know for the past, I've been in the UWC for 10 years,
yes.
9 years now, everyone knows that textbook Billy Madison is the smartest wrestler in the UWC.
Well, X-Rated, you and your old partner, Max Gaeta, were once the longest reigning UWC tag team champion.
1,092 days I was the tag team champion for.
Longest reigning tag team, and you and your, I think the second longest reign was your partner in Johnny Greco. I think you won the titles from them, did you not?
We did. Johnny Greco was already, I think, either retired or sick. I don't know what happened to him. But
right.
Yes, Trey Owens actually filled in for that match. But this isn't about me. And most of the time, a lot of things are about me. This is about Milo taking on Biggie Biggs and becoming the new UWC champion right in front of our eyes.
He just hit that running knee to the corner.
And here it is. This is it. Once.
Only.
See, now, this is the problem I have with the UWC referee. Slow count. I have been screwed in so many matches because of a slow count.
That looks like a pretty fair count to me.
I don't think so. I don't think so at all. See, now, what's Biggie Biggs doing? What, the fan? You can't tag a fan in.
Well, I don't think...
He's trying to tag somebody in.
Oh, Shizo with that big...
Really good.
He might be seconds away from winning the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Listen... He is going to win this title. It's no doubt in my mind.
What kind of champion would he make?
He would make an all right one. I mean, you know, he wouldn't be the best. He's obviously not going to be the biggest champion we've had in the UWC. But he'll definitely be. I'm sure he'll defend his title when need be. Or when he might get forced to. Like, I got forced to defend my tag team titles when I held them. But, you know, it's anything. I think he'll make a great champion.
He just got a big mitt. Right hand to the midsection.
I think Biggie Biggs pulled the tail. I'm not 100%. It looked like it, though.
Off the ropes again.
All right, this is where that size advantage comes in.
Oh!
Come on, that was definitely a pull the tail, pull the hair. I don't pulled something.
No, that looked like a pretty clean slam to me.
Right back up. Miles right back up.
He does have a lot of guts, I will say that. Maybe more guts than brains here. Oh!
Oh, come on!
I think that was an uncle slam right there.
I don't like it one bit.
And Shizo's in trouble. He might be seconds away. Oh, look at this.
Now keep an eye on the Secret Society.
The Secret
this
Society.
Is what I'm saying. Strength of numbers always prevails over just a guy in the fans.
Oh, now look at them. They chickened out. And now they're both in the ring, whether they want to be or not.
Yeah, no, Biggie Biggs brought him into the ring. They're not supposed to be in the ring. They know they're not supposed to be in the ring. Biggie Biggs brought them in. They're not even part of the match. This is completely illegal.
Double choke slam. Well, what power by Biggie Biggs?
This is Biggie Biggs is just cheating this whole match. This whole match is cheating.
Oh! Down low. One, two, three. This one is over. Biggie Biggs retains the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
By cheating, I will add. He was cheated that entire match. Secret Society should not have been in that ring. He brought them in the ring, distracted the referee, pulled the tail. All illegal.
But it worked. Whatever you've used some questionable tactics in the past, especially with that book of yours.
Hey, the textbook just gives me a bad. Yeah, get on.
Look at this. This is it.
Society's on top of him.
3-on-1.
Biggie's getting what he deserves right now.
This is a 3-on-1 assault by the Secret Society.
I'm thinking maybe I'll go into the ring and help them.
No, you gotta stay here at the commentary station. Mike Rivaldi said if any commentator hits the ring, they're in trouble.
All right.
And now look at this. Here we have the Short Bus Express in there trying to even the odds.
This is illegal, but they shouldn't be out. And this is what they're getting. They're getting beat down.
The Short Bus Express getting beat up by the... This is a gang attack. This is uncalled for.
It's completely called for in my book, my textbook, that is. This is a perfect thing right now. I'm loving it.
Oh, look at that. This is an assault. Wait a minute.
Hey, a washing machine just rolled out to the ring.
Shockwave the robot.
Oh, okay.
He's in the ring. Right hands for all the members.
He has all that. He has that loaded fist. What is he doing with that loaded fist? He shouldn't have that.
He's clearing the ring. They shouldn't have been in there.
And now, is he part of this crew? Is he a Short Bus Express member now?
I have no idea.
He kind of looks a little like, you know.
I think he is Silly Billy's favorite wrestler.
Oh, okay. Silly Billy's favorite wrestler. I thought that was me. Thank you.
I apologize for dashing your hopes and dreams.
What are you looking at? Hey, turn around. Action's right there. Action's right there. Don't look at me. I'm commentating over here.
Biggie Biggs, still the UWC Heavyweight Champion.
Now, not to take anything away from those great competitors, but in the back of Biggie's mind, it had to be bothering him. Can I defeat Twiggy Ramirez? He defeated Tom Carter to win that UWC Heavyweight Championship. He didn't defeat Twiggy Ramirez. He had never defeated Twiggy Ramirez in his entire career. All culminated in this big match he had with Twiggy Ramirez at the Browns Mills Rumble on June 4th. Finally gets that big 1-2-3 victory over Twiggy Ramirez. But unfortunately for Biggie Biggs, his night wasn't quite over yet.
Twiggy sizing him up for something. Is this going to be the move that finally puts Biggie Biggs away?
Come on, Biggie! Here we go!
Biggie lost the boot to the midsection.
Uh-oh.
There it is. Cover. 2-3. Biggie Biggs has done it. Biggie Biggs has finally beaten Twiggy Ramirez.
We're not waiting.
That issue isn't done.
Why
I can tell
is Twiggy
you that.
Still out here? Twiggy Ramirez should be barred from ringside.
Oh, he just went for that move that beat.
Yes, English
leg sweep. English leg sweep. Cover. 1-2-3. UWC Heavyweight Championship belt.
So what's next in the career of Biggie Biggs? I have to think he really wants to get his hands on Jeffrey Bravo to try to regain his UWC Heavyweight Championship and become the first ever three-time UWC Heavyweight Champion. I'm sure we'll find out more when the UWC returns to the Browns Mills Firehouse in Browns Mills, New Jersey on September 10th. But before we get there, we have another big show for you right here next week. We're going to take a look at the career of the former UWC Tag Team Champions, Blackhearted Justice. Until then, I'm Chris Wilcox saying so long until next week.